We built an AI-powered SQL playground using Next.js, OpenAI, Neon, and a bunch of cool libraries. Here's what it looks like. The first thing I'll need is a connection string for a Postgres database, and for that, I'll be using Neon. So I'll click connect, paste my connection string, it's connected, and I can view all the tables that are in my database, as well as the different columns, and for each column, I can see its name, its type. We also have a SQL editor where we can write queries and run them, and the results will be displayed in this results panel here on the right. Now, we can click on Ask AI, and we have a dialog that pops up, and we can actually have like a conversation with an AI chatbot about just Postgres and the database schema itself. Now, there are a couple of examples here, but we can actually say something like, what are my tables? And it says your tables are episodes, podcasts, subscriptions, and users, which is correct. Now we can also say something like return 5 episodes. And it's giving me a query. Now I can either copy the query, append the result to the editor in case I want to modify it, or replace the code because I just want to run it right away. So I'll click on replace code. And I'll run it, and we can see we get the results. And we can also see how long the query took to run. So let's actually see how this playground was built. To add the AI functionality to the playground, we're using OpenAI and the Vercel AI SDK. Now, OpenAI provides access to its AI models via an API, and that's what we're going to use. And we're going to use the same model that actually powers ChatGPT, which is super cool. And in case you haven't tried out ChatGPT, I don't know, like you're really missing out. So you should absolutely try it. But anyway, as for the Vercel AI SDK, well, it's an open source library that makes it easy to build AI-powered user interfaces and chat experiences. So let's actually see how we're using both of them in the project. So this is the UI code for the chatbot, and we first have a sheet component, and this is responsible for managing the state of the dialogue, whether it's visible or not. And inside the sheet component, we have a sheet trigger. So this is the button that, when clicked, the dialogue pops up. We have sheet content. So that's actually everything that's inside this dialogue. And we have a header component. So this is the title and description of the dialogue. We have messages, and this component is responsible for rendering the list of messages when we're chatting with the chatbot. And finally, we have a form that contains a prompt component. And this prompt component is actually just made up of the text input here, as well as the submit button. Now, you'll notice that we have a couple of values here. We have input, handle input change, is loading, handle submit, messages. All of these values are actually being pulled from the use chat hook. And this is a React hook that comes from the Vercel AI SDK. And it's super convenient. It gives us the list of messages. So this is just the current messages in the chat. We have the input, so here this will be the prompt that the user provides, and we have a handler for updating this input value. We have a submit handler, so this submit handler, what it will do when the form is submitted, it will actually send a post request to an API endpoint with all of the messages that are provided, which is, again, super convenient. We also have is loading. This is a variable that, like, it's a Boolean that will let us know kind of like whether the kind of request is still processing or not. And we can use this value to display a loading indicator, which is, again, super useful. Now, we also have callbacks. So we have here an on error callback function, and this will be called, well, whenever something goes wrong. And we can use it to display a toast, for example. And last but not least, we actually can include extra data whenever the form is submitted. So we actually include the database schema. So the schema variable here, we're actually pulling it from like state, and we're setting the state from another component, which will include the database schema. So this actually is Jotai, a very cool state management library for React, and it uses a useState-like API. So we're just pulling the schema here, and we're including it whenever we submit the form. And that's actually how the chatbot is able to answer questions about the schema. Now, let's actually see how the API endpoint is implemented. So this is the API endpoint for the chatbot. It is an edge function that accepts post requests, and we're first pulling the messages and the schema from the request body. We're then creating a system message, and this is a message that instructs the AI model on how it should answer questions. So for our case, we want it to only answer questions about Postgres and the user schema, and for it to only return SQL without anything else. We are then creating a new message. So this is the user schema, and we're just passing in the database schema. And finally, we're pulling in the prompt from the messages array. So the prompt, the user prompt, will be the last messages in the array that is sent to the API endpoint. And then finally, we're just using the OpenAI SDK to make a request to the OpenAI API, and we are streaming the response. So that's actually how we get the typewriter effect. And we're passing in the system message, user schema, and prompt as messages to the messages array. And that's it. We then return a stream using the OpenAI stream function and the streaming text response, which are both from the Vercel AI SDK. And that's it. That's how you can build a chatbot using the Vercel AI SDK. And now it's actually time for us to explain how we're pulling the schema information and how we're actually running queries using the Neon Serverless driver. The Neon Serverless driver is a low latency Postgres driver for JavaScript and TypeScript. It allows you to query data from serverless and edge environments like Vercel Edge Functions and Cloudflare Workers, where you can't establish a direct TCP connection. And the way the driver overcomes this limitation is that it provides two options to establish a connection. The first one is querying over WebSockets. This option is designed to be a drop-in replacement for Node Postgres, the popular npm pg package you might be already familiar with. And the second option is querying over HTTP, which offers faster response times for single, non-interactive transactions. Now let's actually see how we're using the serverless driver in the SQL playground. The function used to run queries takes two parameters, a connection string and a query. We first establish a connection to the database, and then we send the query. And we get the result and format it in a way so that we can render it in the results panel. As for the function that pulls the latest schema information, it's a little bit more complicated than that, because it does take a connection string and a schema name, the default one is public. We establish a connection to the database, but then we run multiple queries for getting all the tables, views, functions, triggers, indexes that are in the database. We then format it and return it. And since we now have the different tables, views, and functions, we now can generate a database schema. So this function will generate a single string containing a description of all of these objects. And that's what we pass to the AI chatbot. And because we're passing it, it's able to answer questions based on this new information, which is awesome. We had a lot of fun building this project, and it's actually live. You can try it out at neon.tech/demos/playground. And it's also open source, so you can check out the source code as well. Now, if you have any questions about using Neon with Next.js, about this demo, feel free to reach out. We'd love to hear from you. And with that, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.